promises, kicking off live. So turn your volumes up and get tuned with the vibe. We're rocking on solid, never converse like this before. We rocking on solid, solid, didn't expect a hot cover. We rocking on solid, never converse like this before. We rocking on solid, solid, didn't expect a hot cover.
Hello and welcome to Soul Licks. Thank you for joining us today. I'm Mike Bass, and I'm joined by the beautiful and talented Mo, the beautiful and talented Rose Bush, and the very talented D Hen. Yeah, what up, what up, what up? A little later in the show, we'll be joined by a woman that started her career in the early 90s and hasn't stopped since. She's an actress, a singer, a songwriter, and a producer from the hit group Xscape. And from the stage play Head Over Heels, Tamika Scott will be joining us today. By the way, as always, when you hear the following sound, I don't hear nothing. Oh, there we go. That means it's time for the hot couch, y'all. That's the time when anything goes, no topic is off limits. None. Okay.
No topic?
But for today's topic, man, what are the signs of crazy in a relationship? What are the signs of crazy in a relationship? If you wish to share your thoughts with us, give us a call at 929-477-2668. Again, that's 929-477-2668. We want to hear from you. Okay. What's up, guys? What's the signs of crazy in a relationship? And of course, I got to start with Rosebush crazy. I start with Rosebush because that girl's so crazy.
Wow.
You know,
what's up, Rose?
How did I know you wanted to start with me? Okay, first of all, I
as
am
you
a little
know, crazy.
Darrin, yes, I
Darrin.
Am. But you know, for me, I like a little crazy in the relationship, just a little bit is fun. But when it's over the top, like, signs for me is someone who's constantly calling and texting. Like, for example, a friend of mine, he may call or text if I'm working or if I'm busy and I can't answer right away. Oh, are you mad at me? Oh, what's going on? Oh, are you going up? To me, that's a little crazy. Like, give me a moment. I do have a life. I do have a career. I'm a little busy. Let me respond when I can, sir. So that's a little crazy for me.
That's just a little insecurity. That's some insecurity
that's
a
crazy,
dude that
yeah.
needs
that's crazy.
Needs some manhood in his life. That ain't happening. Yeah.
Because you know, mommy issues, you know, so sometimes I have to play mommy.
What's up, Bo? Hey,
so,
what's going on with you, man? What are the signs of crazy?
So, you know, first of all, I think I have warning signs first, okay? So I usually put up a warning sign, like dangerous mood swings ahead. But on that note, I think, like, my signs would be, you know, this person that insists on knowing your whereabouts at all times. Like, where you at? What you doing? You got a girl over there? You got a bitch over there? I mean, what you doing? You come out the closet. You upstairs. What you doing upstairs? You on the phone? Come on, man. That's a little crazy. Like, you
yeah,
want to know where I'm at every...
security police.
Yes. Do you want to know where I'm at 24 hours a day? Really? No, I'm not doing... We not going to do it.com. How about that?
I know, that's right. Okay, signs are crazy. I think that early on in my life, my father always taught me, when a woman talks, make sure you listen, especially when she talks about herself. So if a woman sits there and be like, man, I don't know how I controlled myself in church. I was about to knock that chick wig off. Like, okay, that's crazy. That's a sign of, okay, that's not,
what?
That's not something that make you be like, ooh, wow, that just turned me on, baby. I can't wait till I get you home. Nah, because before long, that same situation going to be turned on you. All that thing that you think is sexy right there, that little aggression
mm-hmm.
and all that stuff up front, before long, that crap going to be in your bedroom yelling at
mm-hmm.
you all night, every night. So, fellas, pay attention to some of those signs. When a woman talk about herself, listen intensely. That's the time to listen, not the time to run away or block it out. Listen.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? What's up? Who else we got? Who else we got that's on the phone? That's crazy. Oh, we always took care of Rose. Rose, hey, give us one of your other crazy personalities.
You got D-Hen. D-Hen. Don't forget D-Hen. About me.
Give me the crazy baby boy.
Yeah, I agree with you. You know, one of the things that I learned is when we are attracted to something in someone, we have to forget. I mean, we have to remember that when we get it, we are stuck with it, so to speak, right? Like, if you like somebody who's crazy and wild, know that they're always going to be like that. Like, that's what you're getting. If somebody is meek and quiet, you can't 6 months later go, come on, man, be outspoken and a little bit. No, that's what you got. That's what you were attracted to at the time. But that might be the person's energy. So, yeah, you got to be careful with stuff like that because, you know, once you get it, you got it.
So let me ask the gentleman on the line. Let me ask both of you a question. If you meet a young lady and just say she hypothetically kind of snaps off because something happened, does that necessarily, like, just she's at a restaurant and maybe she didn't get her food was a little cold and she kind of went off on a waiter? Would you call that signs of crazy, or she just had an episode at that moment? Or would you run scared to the door?
It's both. I think she crazy and she had an episode. She should have known, first of all, where she was. I mean, you know, now that's with everybody. That goes for dudes, too, inside the restaurants. You know, you got to know where you at. Of course, you got to control that anger, and everything's going to tip you off sometimes, you know. But come on, you still have to know your surroundings. Now, as far as a woman just being that outspoken and going at it like that, yeah, I'm going to have one eye open every time I go to sleep. It's not something I'm going to be, like, feeling safe about.
Okay, now I got something to say about that, Mo. Really, and the reason I got something to say about this is because this happened last week to me. Y'all ready for this? Rose, y'all ready for this? Okay.
Yeah, I'm ready.
Me and my lady are out, right? So we go out, we go to this event, and after the event, we go out with our friends. I'm going to leave them nameless. Right? We go out to dinner, and somebody mentioned something at the table, and I guess somebody was somewhere they weren't supposed to be a year ago. Well,
wow.
The woman started questioning at the table. The guy gets up, who I'm going to leave nameless, and he walks away. And then when he comes back, he finds out that she was trying to ask me all these questions about him. And they just started yelling. Now, we're in this posh restaurant. They start screaming on each other. And I'm like, y'all cannot do this here. Like, people know who all of us are, and they wild out. So he started to leave, and I said, look, you can't leave your woman here. Like, come back, sit down at the table. And he starts going, nah, man, I'm tired of this, blah, 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 blah. And so I calmed him down. So when he went to leave, because he was still going to leave her, he left her. Now, I got a two-seater Porsche. I can't drive her home. Both of my seats are full. So we were going to call her Uber, and then she said, I'll do it myself. Well, we kind of talked to her, and we left because we didn't want to be involved in all the picture taking that was going on because it was going to be a lot of gossip. Well, long story short, she called him to come back. He came back to the restaurant. They got into a bigger argument. She smacked him. He or she called the cops, and it turned into a big thing. Now, I promise you, I had no idea that either one of these people had this in them. So you just got to be careful because you don't really know a person until something, you know, rushed them the wrong way, and then it all came out. But I couldn't believe what I was watching because both of these people are grown-ass men and women, right? They're grown.
Right.
And I was not expecting this to happen. And, you know, my lady and I, we left. And I was like, look, we ain't staying here because we ain't involved in this. This is between them. But, you know, we didn't expect anything like that to jump off. So, I mean, you never know.
Wow.
Right. You never know. But now you see the signs of crazy.
I got a whole bunch, though. I got some juicy stuff to tell. But we're going to keep going with the show. Like, you can keep going. But I have one more that I really want you guys to ponder this until we get back to it. But what about, I know we talk about cray-cray and all of it, I mean, crazy, and I think most of it reflects to the woman from what I'm hearing, but what about a guy that just vents on social media? Not all told all at once, you know?
Oh, my God.
What about that? What does that mean?
Now, if it's
like,
if his trigger fingers don't went to Twitter fingers, we got a problem. You know what I'm saying?
Okay. It's like, all right. Well, we can come back to that one. But anyway, because we need to, you know, I want to welcome our guest. But go ahead, Mike.
Hey, what's up today? All right, cool. At this time, we would like to welcome to our show from the hit group Xscape and the stage play Head Over Heels, the beautiful and talented Miss Tamika Scott. What's up? Welcome to the show, Tamika.
Hold up. Thank you. What are the drum rolls and the whistles and the claps? I want to have all
that.
All there.
All there.
You want me to sing a note? You want me to sing a note, too? You want me to sing a note?
No, please don't do that.
I was in the backpack. Hey, Tamika. Thank you for being on Soulix tonight.
Hi. I'm good. How y'all doing?
We doing good.
How
you doing?
I'm good. I'm kind of offended right now because I think y'all talking about me on the fly. That is crazy in a relationship.
You
crazy? I'm on the borderline of normal. I'm almost there. But, you know, it's going to take a couple of...
Now, what y'all don't know is that Tamika and I are like brother and sister, and I think I got a story that I might tell on the radio about one of Tamika's crazy experiences with being a little psycho.
Wow.
Oh, yes.
Uh-oh.
You know, in the beginning of a relationship, everybody come with their gang face. Everybody's they on their best behavior. The guys open the door, open the car door. They pay for the check. You know, in the beginning, the girls they real nice and they dress up, put their makeup on, they smell good on. Like everybody be on their game in the beginning. But as time go, you can only front for so long. The real you is gonna come out. Now, hopefully,
before you
fall in love with him or her, that you will see the crazy before you fall in love. Because once you fall in love, you just actually got to deal with it. So
That's true. With that being said,
I have some crazy things going on in the beginning. I am happily married. Me and my husband, we are best friends. But, you know, it took time to get to where we are right now. And I know Darrin said, he could tell you some things. Darrin once called us, in the beginning of our relationship, he once called us dysfunctional.
Okay.
I can see D saying that, too.
So what would you call dysfunctional? Let me know some of that. What does that entail?
Okay, I'm going to break this down. Okay. Her husband is like that's my man. That's like one of my best brothers. That's my big brother. Tamika is my sister. So I love you for being on the show today. We can't wait to hear your stories and just how life is for you right now. But I got to tell you about dysfunction. Okay, so Tamika and her husband were arguing one day, and it was around his birthday. And he decided to leave the house because he got pissed off. Now, the house is full of people. He gets in the car. Tamika jumps on the hood of the car, and he pulls off. And she is on the car sliding, and it's driving. And I said, they're dysfunctional.
Now, I'm the type of person. Okay, let me give you a little insight. My husband, he's from the north. He's from New York. I'm from Georgia.
Okay.
So it's different, you know, up north, not just over north. I'm sure other guys, when guys get upset, they like to leave to cool down. But I'm the type of person, we're going to sit here, we're going to talk it out, ain't nobody leaving the house. We're going to lock the doors. We're just going to face each other. I'm that type. Well, I used to be that type of person. Like, you're not leaving. But that day, he thought he was going to leave. And I was like, oh, really? So I jumped on top of the hood like, no, we're going to talk about this. And he bagged about the driveway. I was like, this Negro is crazy.
You jumped through the hood, but he crazy. I'm not even going there, but okay. We'll go for that. But we know that was y'all little foreplay. You know what I'm saying? Him being from New York, that was the beginning of our relationship.
Yeah, that was the beginning. But now, you know, we're grown with it. So we have like a safety word that we use whenever the other person gets mad. We have a safety word. I don't care how angry. angry he gets or how angry I get, we have a safety word. And when that person says it, you have to stop. And sometimes we just bust out laughing. So whatever we're mad about, it goes away. So it's a certain word that we use, and it just everything just stops.
Now, are y'all talking about bondage? Are y'all talking about bondage, or y'all talking about relationships right here? Like, what are we talking about? Safety word?
No, when I say no, I call it a safety word because that's the word that I don't care how angry you are, you stop and you look at each other and we tell each other, I love you. We're going to get past this, but I need to leave out for a minute. And
let's call it a different word. Let's call it a love word. Let's not call it a safety word, because safety word is a bondage term. You know you're going too
far.
Yeah,
we have a safety word for that as well. Yeah, we have a safety word for that as well.
I know that jumping in a car could be dysfunctional. But, I mean, I don't think guys realize that when you take a woman to a certain extent, she's capable of doing anything. It doesn't mean that she's crazy or she has these tendencies. But, I mean, there's so much you can take, and it's so much you take a lot. You take a lot before you explode to do stuff like that. Now,
right.
I guess it's the thing about, you know, from being up north, you know, we handle things a little bit different. But, Tamika, to be honest, up north, not only would a chick jump on your car, she'd have bust your windows out, okay?
The windows?
So
Just
jumping in the car.
I wasn't trying to go to jail. I was just trying to not make him leave the house. That's all.
You jumping in the car was probably like him, like a flashback moment from his younger days. Because I'm telling you, like, I have to say, like, I don't know about New York, D, but I know, and Mike can consider Philly's chicks is crazy. No, those are crazy. Some of them are crazy. I done seen some situations where I had my mouth open wide, like, did this just happen? And they just don't care. They just don't care. Like, you're my man, and when I tell you to stop and you're doing something, we're having an argument, and you walk away from me, they're liable to pick up something and knock in your head, chase you down the street, jump on your back.
So, ladies, with that being said, ladies, if your man is angry and wants to leave, let him go. Let him cool off and come back.
Did I mention about 250 pounds pure muscle? Did I mention that?
It's funny because I'm 5'1", 150 pounds, and he's like 6'3", 260, all muscles. So, yeah.
We rest our case. You are definitely cray cray. Rest our case for that one. And you cray cray. Okay, you win the cray cray award today, baby girl. For real. Oh my God.
Shortly after that, we got married. So I guess it worked.
I can see that happening.
Y'all want to own that crazy this time. Y'all just want to own it. Like, hey, we going to own this crazy. Let's get married.
He was like, this a real ride or die chick. This a real ride or die chick. Let's get married.
Let me ask the gentleman. I know, you know, we spoke about some cray-cray moments, but, like, Darrin, have you ever had a cray moment happen, a crazy, crazy moment happen to you? I mean, I know about the DM and all that other stuff, but I'm just talking about some serious craziness happened to you where you were standing with your mouth open.
Yeah, like when I was in my I think I was cray cray too. But when I was in my early 20s, I was away. I was performing, and I had gone away, and I came back home a day early.
Uh-oh.
And when I got home, I went to put the key in my door, and I heard some rustling going on. And so I knocked on the door, and then I heard some whispering going on. And then I didn't use the key anymore. I kind of kicked my door open. So I was the cray in cray cray. But when I busted the door open, this was like when I was like 24. When I busted the door open, her and the dude were still trying to get dressed.
Wow.
And what she said,
I can't tell you the end of the story, but what she said was it wasn't her fault. Now, that's
what?
Crazy to me. When I was 24
what?
Years old, that happened. And like I said, I can't tell you how the rest of the story goes, but but if you can imagine getting busted and then saying it's not my fault, almost like he forced me to do this. You
wow.
get people who will. You get people. I mean, think about it. I mean, you know, he didn't go to jail, no jail time. But think about it. R. Kelly said it wasn't him. This girl had urine.
24 times.
That yeah, that had R. Kelly's, you know, DNA in it, but he said it wasn't him. That's cray cray. So, to me, that kind of stuff, it all goes in the same thing. It's like, who are you with, and what are they capable of?
Man, yeah, that's true. I had one situation. I was like, you know, and this was like crazy to me. Because it wasn't even my fault. Now, this is the funny part. It wasn't my fault. Now, pay attention, okay? So, I'm at a club, and I'm just chilling, right? I'm chilling with all my boys. We drinking and everything. We getting a little turnt. This is early days, you know. So, chick walks up to me, throws her drink in my face,
ooh.
Yells at me some BS about some. Dude, I have no idea what she was talking about to this day because I didn't even know the chick. I didn't even know her. Dude, I didn't even know her at all. Never met her a day in my life. Like, I remember every face of everybody damn near that I've met. I mean, it's crazy. My memory is sick like that. I won't remember your name, but I remember your face, your event, what you were wearing. You know what I'm saying? Dude, I'm sitting there, like, in a white sports coat with a red drink all over me, dumbfounded, trying to explain to my boys what happened when I don't even know. I'm like, dude, what is going on? Never saw her again in my life, though. That's the funny part about it. I think I was getting poked that day. It's a rap, man. I was looking for cameras. I was like, okay, something going on here. It's something. But, yeah, that's a crazy chick for you. You know what I'm saying? If anybody see a little brunette chick with freckles on her face, big old wide nose, just about 5'4", about 122 pounds, you know what I'm saying? Look around. Look around. She look crazy.
You know she's listening, right? You know she's listening. She gonna throw another drink in your face. She listening
Tamika.
Right now. Oh, he talking about me? You talking about me?
Tamika,
oh my God. Y'all crazy.
Do you ever get any crazy fans who approach you in any way?
Yes.
Oh my
yes.
God.
Tell us a little
bit.
I know
Mike, you could I'm sure you have a lot of stuff. I remember one time somebody came and knocked on my door and had on like a coat with nothing under it. A dude.
I would hope so. I was a dude for you.
Oh, you know what? Oh, believe me, we don't got some crazy women now.
Oh,
we don't got
my
some crazy
God.
Women. One girl had her name tattooed on her arm.
Oh.
And I didn't know what to say. You know, I didn't want to say thank you. I didn't know whether to say security or, you know, I didn't know what to say. But yeah, it's a lot of crazy stories out there that make you be like,
oh my God.
Yeah,
there's a lot of crazy stories out there. You're right. You are right, indeed. So a chick came up to me with base tattooed onto her ass cheek. Base tattooed on her ass cheek. Yep.
Wow.
I was like, okay.
So how do you know it was tattooed when you saw it?
Yeah,
oh,
like,
dude,
looking
she
at it, like, what's up with that?
Dude, she pulled down her pants in public and showed it to me. We were in public.
Oh, my goodness. That's crazy.
Wow.
For real. You my favorite member. I was like, now how you going to prove that? Look, she put dude had it on her right butt
wow.
face. I'm like,
you're
crazy.
You,
man.
Crazy.
I married her. You know, it just turned me on so much. I ended up marrying her. I'm sorry, y'all. No, I'm just joking. I ain't married.
Oh, oh,
out of control.
You a mess.
What is up? Okay, cool. So we all know about crazy now. You know what I'm saying? But hey, Nick, let's find out about you. Okay. Most people don't know that you ended up. You're a writer. That you wrote for Jaheim, Yolanda Adams, Anthony Hamilton, come on, Music Soul Child, and Xscape throughout the years, and many, many others, man. Tell us about that process, man. Tell us about the bunch of stuff that they do not know about Tamika.
Well, I was blessed to be able to write and act both. You know, acting is my first love, even though I started singing first with my sister, Latasha. She's also in, she was in the group Xscape as well. So I was really made to sing. My mom made me sing. But, you know, after we disbanded, I was able to write. I was able to act and just be a part of Tyler Perry's soundtracks. I wrote some songs for his movies. I wrote some songs for one of his plays. And I also played Malay in Meet the Browns. So I had the opportunity to venture off and enjoy success by myself. But now I'm currently starring in the number one gospel comedy stage play, Head Over Heels, written by Lolita Snipes.
That's what's up. Tell us about it.
It's about a young attorney who's, you know, real successful, real sweet girl, family oriented. She falls in love with a bad boy. So, with that being said, her life changes, but she still have her family there to try to guide her. So it gets to the point where it's almost like you got to choose between your family and your man. And I play the best friend. I play the best friend of the attorney. I'm that crazy chick. Everybody have that one crazy friend. Everybody. I play that crazy friend, that person who looks up to her and just admires her. I wear her clothes. I want to be like her. I just don't have that book sense, but I have a lot of street sense type of thing.
Okay.
Yeah.
Right. So, it sounds like it's going to be a good play.
It is a great play. I mean, we have Kenny Lattimore. We have Jennifer Nesbitt. She's a Broadway actress. The comedian, HBO comedian, Tony Tone. Oh, it's a great play. It is a must-see play.
I think so. Hey, y'all make sure y'all go and support this play. Sounds like it's going to be a lot of damn fun. Hey, growing up in the church, Mika, and being a preacher's kid, man, how did that influence your music, especially coming out with Xscape, like after, you know, being in the church all day, every day? What's up with that?
Well, I think
how did that influence?
By being in the church, you can really hear the sound. I think our sound has, when you hear us sing, it's that gospel tone. It's a little different than R&B. So you can hear that, the melody, the way we sung, the way we took it to church on our bridges. It helped out a lot. Now, we weren't able to listen to blues until we were at least in middle school. We had to wear dresses every day. It was a lifestyle. Growing up with Church of God in Christ, we had a certain lifestyle. You couldn't wear makeup. You couldn't wear braids. You couldn't wear fingernail polish. Your skirts had to be below your knees, and you had to wear a prayer cloth on your head. So, when I graduated high school, I couldn't wait. No, just saying.
Yes. I remember those times. Yes.
I know it was a big change. I saw a picture with you with fishnets. With a thong on stage, with fishnets over
top. You're in the hot couch. Wait a minute. Let's remind her again. You are now.
That's what that sound is.
On the hot couch.
In the hot couch.
Okay.
Yes.
Take it
Here
away, Rose.
Tamika, before I get into, you know, what I have to get into on the hot couch. First of all, I would like to say, if only the callers could see how I am smiling ear to ear, because the crazy in me receives the crazy in you, and I'm just loving it right now that, you know, I can actually relate to someone else's craziness. I love it. Yes.
Yeah, you a man.
Okay. Now, on to the topic. So, a few years ago, you know, allegedly, Xscape was not going to have a reunion. Candy did not want to reunite with you because, you know, she claimed that you lied on her publicly about sleeping with Jermaine Dupri and some other people. So I just kind of want to know, what was your intent, you know, if this really did happen? And apparently you did apologize to her. And have you or will you apologize publicly for those lies that you allegedly said about her?
Well, first of all, you crazy. First of all, where did you get that from? Where did you get all that from? Who told you about that?
I've read it in a few articles.
Do you know how long ago that interview was? That was over 10 years ago.
Yep.
10 years ago.
So what happened? Because you sound mighty evasive right now. We won't know what happened.
Wow, that was so long ago. I don't even, look, I'm like.
You remember.
Right now, first of all, let me state one thing. First of all, I never lied about anything.
Okay.
Second of all, I really don't want to talk about something that happened years ago that's not relevant today. So,
yeah.
You know, we moved on. Back then, I was a little different than now. You know, you say something to me, I was ready to fight and I would expose whatever, but now I'm grown. You know, I'm happy, I'm married, I have girls that look up to mommy. So I'm trying to set examples for my kids, so I'm no longer that person. I never once lied about anything, but I don't want to talk about something from the past.
Okay.
Okay.
So she made it abundantly clear she didn't lie. Okay. She was sorry for exposing it, but not for telling the truth. So
okay,
there we go. So we're gonna move on.
Yes, we're gonna move on. Candy smashed JD, and there he is.
No, did y'all see On Song? Did y'all get a chance to see On Song?
I sung On
Song.
No, I
didn't see that one.
I did.
You did.
Maybe you should take notes. Mr.
Tamika, I have a question for you. Out of all of the songs that you sing as a group together, when you were together, what were your favorite songs to sing together? And was it duet that you had with your sister or the whole group Xscape itself?
I think two of my favorite songs, the first one was Understanding, because we all sang lead on it, and just where we were in our life at that time, that song was like a testament for all of us, the things that we were going through. And then my second favorite, I want to say, is Who Can I Run To? That's a song that my sister and I sang. And we were able to, it was like being back in church on the stage singing together. It was, you know, I love singing that. That's like one of my favorite Xscape songs ever. Who Can I Run To? Which is a remake from the Jones Girls.
I would have to say that tonight I picked those two very songs. That's crazy.
Wow.
I was just like, those are my favorite songs, but I picked those two songs tonight. So on that note, let's just listen to a little bit Understanding.
Represented a time and space that was moving forward, especially with people of color in America that spoke for us. And you know, we really always hold on to those times and the songs that the group sang. It really represented a movement for us as well, so we thank you for that. But I have a question for you. Moving forward with your career now and the songwritings, I know about a song that you have, like when you said that you wrote that for Tyler Perry, it was called The Greatest Gift. Where did you get that inspiration from? What
inspiration,
was that song about?
Make sure y'all check it out. You can check it out on YouTube, or you can go to www.tamikascott.com to check that out. But YouTube is called Greatest Gift. That song was inspired by my greatest gift, which is my husband. So I was able to write exactly how I felt and how he made me feel. And when I was recording it in the studio, I was crying so much I could barely finish the song. But it is a song about my husband. It is him. It is nothing made up. It is him 100%. Like, he is one of the best people in the world. He is the best husband, the best father. He is definitely my soulmate. I don't know what I would do without him. God has truly blessed me. And it's crazy. As a little girl, you pray for certain things, and I got what I prayed for. So when I tell y'all, I am the happiest girl alive. And fairy tales are true, because we have a fairy tale love.
Wow. Congratulations.
So real love is true, y'all. Just be patient. If you're looking for it, be patient. It's out there. Because we come from two separate worlds, and we clicked. Like, I have his rib in me.
Mm.
You know what they say? When God created woman, he took the rib from the man. I have his rib inside of me. So that song is definitely
great.
Check it out. When you hear
it,
check it out.
I
Greatest
love
gift.
It. So we do have another caller. I'm going to bring Marvin, Marvelous, to the line. I know you guys know him.
Marvelous, Marvin's on
hey,
the phone,
Marvin.
For real.
Surprise.
What's up, Marvelous? Marvelous.
Hello. Hey, Mike, I spoke to you last week, and you told me about this platform. I decided to tune in. Hello, Tamika.
Hi, Marvin. How are you?
I'm doing quite well. Keep going. I've been tuning in all evening, and I'm proud of you all, and I look forward to some fabulous things, and I like the lineup and the whole concept, and I think this is going to be something that's going to be taken worldwide. Congratulations, everybody.
Thank you, Marvin.
Marvelous.
M to the What's up, Mike?
Hour.
Mike.
Yes, sir.
Y'all doing
What's
major
up, family?
Things there. So, hey, I'm excited to hear all this. So, and Xscape is well underrated. They're one of the superstar groups of our generation, and I'm so glad you got this young lady on the phone. She's very dear to me and my family. So, congratulations once again. And
nice.
I'm tuned in, so keep doing what y'all doing, and we're definitely going to stay in touch.
That's what
Thank
about
you.
Marvelous.
Thank you, Marvelous.
Okay,
thank you, Marv.
No problem.
Right.
I'll stay in touch. God bless y'all.
God bless. Bye.
Bye-bye.
That's too cool, man. Okay. Y'all got Marvelous. That's what's up, man. That's a great dude right there, man. Him and Miss Loretta, man. Most incredible people out there, man. Incredible.
Mm-hmm.
You guys don't know who Marvelous is.
He's one of the premier road managers that was out and making things happen on the road.
Man, yes. It still is. Still with Johnny Gill, still with all of them.
Yeah.
Bobby, all of them. He's still with everybody, man. If he was us, man, he's still with everybody. Yep. Blessings to you. Blessings to you, Marvelous. That's what's up. Hey.
So let me ask you guys a question. Back to the crazy relationships. Just listen to what everyone has experienced and things that has happened to you guys. Have you ever felt like through those crazy moments that while you were in it, did you feel like, you know, you couldn't get out of it? Like, do you feel like you could have been a different person or had done something differently? Because I know sometimes, like, you know, we all try to remain calm through situations and, you know, show respect. But sometimes you just have to go crazy because people take advantage of your niceness. So getting back to what I said earlier in regards to, kind of exploiting yourself on social media, would you take the approach if something happened to you that was crazy, would you go to social media and talk about it? Or would you talk about it with someone close to you? How do you feel about people kind of exploiting, like, crazy stuff like that on social media?
See, with me, it depends on if it's a man or woman, okay? Is this a situation with a dude exploiting it or a woman exploiting it?
It doesn't matter.
I agree.
Whichever one.
I agree with Mike.
It really depends.
It makes a huge difference. Women can be emotional and they get a pass. But when a man does it, those are feminine fingers. We call those feminine
fingers.
There
you go. There you go.
You just said feminine fingers. Oh, my God.
See, now that's why I was about to ask, because I was about to say this dude is, like, kind of floating right now.
Wait a minute.
He ain't even touching the ground.
Wait a minute. Okay, I may be a little slow. What is feminine fingers? As
feminine
I pour my second glass of wine.
Feminine fingers is a man who goes to social networks to put his business out there. A real man is going to communicate, talk to the woman, even if he's disappointed or if he's excited about something. But he's not going to go to a social network to blast his business out for the world to read. A man that does that has feminine fingers. He's in his femininity.
Yeah, and he might be cheating to his boyfriend.
So when you say
cheating to his boyfriend at the time,
does that necessarily mean that there's some sweetness going on, or it's just some tendencies happening?
Okay, it depends on how irate it was. What was the rant? what was he talking about?
Mike, let me help you out. Let me help Mo get to what she's trying to get to. So Mo,
please do.
Your boy crush, your man crush, who we won't say any names.
We're not doing that.
Oh.
He has those tendencies.
Oh,
no,
snap.
Is that a... Excuse me?
So this is a real dude. This is a real dude. Okay.
No, stop it.
I'm not supposed to say anything. Okay, my bad.
Who's your man crush, Mo?
I don't have one. What I'm saying
they don't sound like much of a. She is right. She don't have one. Well, they don't sound like much of a man.
Anyway, what I'm saying is y'all taking this to the left, and I'm being serious.
We'll just say her man crush takes to social networks and gets on there and has emotional fingers, feminine fingers, and blasts and puts his business out there. Opposed to maintaining his thoughts and dealing with them personally, he lashes out on social media. That's a form of weakness.
So you
yeah,
think?
Lonely,
so what y'all are saying that it's okay for a woman
a
to do
dude.
That and not a man?
Sometimes people, if you don't have someone to talk to. And just say everyone you kind of talk to is very, very negative when you try to talk to them. So sometimes you may draw to something to get a response. Does that necessarily mean that you have sweet tendency? If I have a problem with somebody, I'm going to go directly to that problem. I'm not going to take it to social media and do all of that. I'm just not going to do that.
If we look at,
I'm going to go to the source
right.
and say, this is what's bothering me. Can you handle this or can we resolve this?
That is the
exactly.
correct way to do it. But if you look
exactly.
at what's going on right now, and I'm going to say these two names, and everybody knows who I'm talking about, Sierra and Future. Like, you don't put your business out on social media. She's naming her son after the new guy she's dating now. Her son was named after Future before. Now she wants to, like, we don't need to know that. And then he's blasting her. Like, you got to understand that the one that's caught in the middle is the son. He's going to be able to read all of this. He's going to be able to see this later on in his life. Like, you don't do that. You don't put your business on blast. It's not really our business to know what's going on in your life. So when people start talking about they want privacy, well, then you don't use social networks as a regurgitation tool to find out about your business. And when a man does that, he's not really being a man, because a man is supposed to protect and provide. So
Amen.
You don't blast your business out
there you
on
go.
Social media.
So let me ask you a question. I've been a victim of it. I've done this before, and I could have been wrong because I was in a different headspace. So, say, example, you have been in a situation with somebody, you break up or whatever, and sometimes, you know, you don't have that avenue to conversate with them because you know if you conversate with them, it's going to blow up. So you st- still out in the windows. Like, you may put a post out there, but you know what I mean? It always says, if the dog screams, you know the rock hit him. So my thing is that wrong to just throw in the windows out there?
Well, again, if you throw stuff out there, Mike, you can chime in on it, but you have to know that if you're throwing stuff out there, your intention is to pull his skin. Your intention is to get his attention. Then why don't you text him directly? Why do it on social networks?
I think you're trying to do more than get his feathers ruffled. I think you're trying to really, really hurt him. I'm talking about, you're not throwing a little rock, you're throwing boulders. It's like, man, you're just trying to really, really get at him in a way that you know best, and that's by embarrassment, you know?
Exactly.
And,
you know. And that's quantified by the World Wide Web. So not only are you telling him how you feel about him, but you're telling everyone else how you feel about him, which makes sometimes people feel a lot bigger because they feel like, well, more people know how I feel. But it doesn't make your situation better, and it doesn't bring healing to the situation. What you want to do is you want to bring understanding, right, Tamika? Understanding. You want to bring healing
right,
to a situation.
Right.
You want to bring overstanding to the situation. And somewhere along the line, and this is what I've always learned, you can't be mad at somebody or angry at somebody unless you love them that much, because it's really a game of polarity, right?
Mm-hmm.
If you put in the time, if you got into a point of emotion with that person and they disappointed you in any way, the reason that you're disappointed that much is because you put that much in. But really what you want to do is you want them to know how much you care. You want them to know, how you really feel, and you want to be understood. And if people can be understood, they won't be on social networks having feminine fingers, especially men. Women get a pass because you guys are emotional.
I'm going to start using that, feminine fingers. I like that term.
Feminine fingers.
That's going to be my That's going to be my line for the week, feminine fingers. What do you think, Tamika?
What'd you say? I'm sorry.
I said, what do you think about all of this?
I agree with Darrin. I mean, when you're younger, like myself, like even with the question you asked me earlier, you know, when you're younger, you do things, you say things. And then once you get older, you say, okay, you know what, let me handle this a little differently. And me going on social network, you know, saying this about my man or saying this about my woman, that's not the way to handle it. Once you become a man and once you become a woman, then you'll see the right way to do it. Until then, you could be 40 years old, you could be 50, ranting. That'll mean you've grown up or you mature. You could still
right,
be in that
exactly.
childish era in your life.
Mm-hmm.
So it's really the maturity of the person, because I look at it like it's easy to say, you know, a man shouldn't do this, but a woman. But when a person get their heart broken and they don't know how to deal with certain things and don't know how to handle it, they may do that. Not saying it is right, but, you know, you never know a person's background or what makes them tick or what makes them do that. But when you do become that man and that woman, then you say, okay, I'm going to handle it a little differently. So
okay.
That's how I feel.
I agree.
Okay.
I concur.
You're not going to be cray-cray about it no more. That's what's up. Okay.
Right, right. My cray-cray days are over.
and that's true. Like, as you mature, you put those things aside, you know, because you are setting an example. For whether it's kids or someone who looks up to you or someone
right.
you know, just basically who respects you in the industry. So you just don't want to just go around just doing unnecessary things to diminish the person that you are. You know what I mean? Because we all have grown to build that up, to build who we are. And we don't want anybody, and not even ourselves, to tear that down. Because at the same
right.
time, you're sitting here like, I work so hard to get where I am right now. Why am I going to tear myself down or let somebody
right.
else take me to that level to tear me down? You know, you have
that.
To kind of stand forth and say, you know what, I'm better than that. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to handle this situation a little bit differently. I'm going to think about it before I react, because that's what we do. We react first. Before we even, you know what I mean, we think about it. We don't have a thought process. We just react. So now,
that's
as you grow in maturity, you know what? Let's think about it. What are the consequences if I do it this way? Or what are the consequences
right.
if I do it the right way? You know what I mean? Because you always want the favorable term to be approached at all costs. So,
exactly.
you know, I just feel like...
Mike and I ain't saying that you're crazy. We're just saying crazy-ish.
There we go. We just gonna say it's a little crazy-ish. There you go.
I just think that both of you. I just think that both of you are crazy. How about that?
Well, I agree. I accept my craziness. I mean, you didn't say nothing new. It's like you just informed the world about something that they didn't know. No.
But God ain't
through
with me yet.
Yes.
What'd you say, Darrin? What'd you say, Dehan?
I said, God ain't through with me yet.
I know that's right. Work in progress. Man. Oh, my God. And speaking of crazy. Rose, what's up with you, man? What's going on, Rose?
How did I know you were going to do that? You, I mean, honestly,
that you crazy?
I am a little touched, but, you know, sometimes I do things. And before
Hold on,
I
wait,
do
before
it,
you
I
do that,
myself.
Wait a minute, Rose. What person are we today? I just want to know what personality we are right now.
I'm Mary Elizabeth.
Okay, cool. All
okay.
Right.
We got Mary Elizabeth on the line. Go ahead, talk about it.
I'm
crazy.
I'm Mary Elizabeth, yes. Okay, so, like, a lot of times before I do things, I tell myself, Mary, Rose, whoever you are at this moment, don't do it. You know it's not right. You know what's going to happen. You know what the consequences are. But sometimes it just feels good to do it anyway, you know, and ask for forgiveness later. But on a serious note, I tell myself I over E, and that's intelligence over emotions. Because a lot of times, you know, we use our emotions, but I never want to put myself in a situation to where my emotions will damage business or get in the way of making money. So just, you know, remember that, guys. I over E, intelligence over emotions.
Do you look in the
yes.
mirror when you say it?
Sometimes.
I just want to know, you know, because you really talk to yourself out loud like that. I just want to know if you're looking at yourself, too. I need a picture of the creek.
Well, Mike, I don't think that's fair, Mike, because I mean
what?
It's okay to talk to yourself just as long as you don't answer back. Sometimes you gotta
answer
in
herself
and
back. But she
answer back. You can talk.
You know what?
You just
you
don't
know,
have to answer back. As you start answering back, that's a little crazy. But if you could, I mean, some people, just think about it. I'm quite sure everybody on this call, all the listeners, have had one moment that you stood there and you've said, whatever it could have been, you've talked to yourself, damn, I look good today. Or, man, do I need to do that today? Don't even go there. I'm quite sure you've talked to yourself. Now, whether you answer back, that's a different story. But I'm quite sure you talked to yourself. And you can sit there and deny it if you want to, but, you know, hey. I talk to myself. I'm my best, you know, I'm my best conversation. I mean, I just don't answer.
You know what they call those
situations? Hey, D, what do we call those people?
We call those situations, and Tamika knows because she's a songwriter. She writes about stuff like this. We call those situations challenge, choice, and outcome. Challenge.
And we call those people challenge, choice, and outcome. No.
Right?
When
we're faced with situations, those are our challenges. But then we still have to make conscious choices. And based upon the choices, are we going to get our outcomes? Right? So that's really what it is. Our challenges, our choices, and our outcomes. That's within relationships. That's in dealing with ourselves. That's in everything in life. That's with jobs, challenge, choice, and outcomes.
So if you challenge yourself to make a choice and get the outcome you receive, you're going to be in a mental home because that's crazy. No, I'm just checking on y'all, man. Come on. I don't talk to myself like that much.
Yes, you do talk to yourself.
Yeah,
like
it's
I
really,
said, much.
Really,
I don't talk to myself
it's
much.
Really it's really important when we do self-discovery because, you know, on this show we talk about every kind of topic, but when we talk about relationships, when we talk about, and that's another thing I think that we're going to go into down the road. What is the difference between a relationship and a one-ship? Those are two different things.
Yeah.
So, you know, those are topics that we're going to talk about later on, I'm sure, at some other time. But it's wonderful. Tamika, we still have you on the line?
I'm here, baby.
We
I am here.
Tamika's not leaving. She can't leave us.
Oh, I'm not going nowhere. I'm here.
Yes.
Tamika, it's not really about being crazy or anything, but, you know, as a mom and as a wife and having a career and being in the industry, how do you balance work and family life? And, you know, what can you tell, like, mothers and wives out there who want to get into the industry or just really take off in their career, but they're kind of torn between family and work?
I think, I want to say that I have a supportive family. Like, my family's supportive, my mom, my husband's mom. Everybody's always here to give a hand. If it's keeping, you know, we just had a two-year-old. I started over, I got a 22-year-old, and we started over, we got a two-year-old. So if it's giving hands, helping with the baby, or come and cooking, or, you know, while I'm out of town, I have, like, a great support group. So it makes it easy for me. Now, if I didn't have that, it would be challenging. It really would. But to everybody who has a dream, aspiration, something that you want to do, you're never too old. One thing I hate is when people say, how old are you? You want to sing? You 30? Oh, you too old. As long as you got breath in you and you got a talent from God, you are never too old to act, to sing, to write, to start a business, whatever business that you want to start. I don't care if you're 69. If you're still alive and breathing, you can do it. Don't let nobody stop you. You can only stop yourself. So you get around people that's going to encourage you, that's going to build on your dreams. I say it like this. I ask God to get rid of the people that subtract and divide in my life and bring those people that add and multiply, and that I can do the same. So you surround yourself by people that add and multiply towards your gift, that's going to pray with you and agree with you and speak those things. That's what you do. Don't let no one or nobody stop you from reaching your destiny.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. I almost felt like I was in church right there.
For real.
Pass the
I mean, that's true, because you have a lot of people who don't see your dreams. A lot of people can't. They don't see, you know, your vision, because they're not the visionary of what your vision is. So sometimes you just got to be quiet, sit back, educate yourself, and work hard towards that vision. Then when it comes to pass, that's when everybody's going to be saying, girl, I knew you could do it, boy. I knew. I've been here all alone. No, you wasn't. You wasn't. But, you know, you gotta believe in yourself. That's all it's about. Faith in yourself, believe in yourself.
That's what's up.
Amen.
Okay.
I know y'all hit the little one.
Amen.
I can't help but believe. Right. You know, I think that it starts with self. You know what I mean? Everything you do starts with self. If you don't believe in yourself, how are you able to, you know, administer anything that you're feeling or any creative thought or any creative process into the world if you don't believe in yourself?
Right.
Because no one else is going to believe in you. You know, it's almost like you're fraudulent. You're fraudulent. You know what I mean? Like, you know, instead of taking that approach, you know, you've got to understand, like, and I always take the approach, like, I look at myself first before I look at others. You know, if it's something that I'm doing that is not favorable, then guess what? If it's not favorable to me, it's not going to be favorable to someone else. So I'm going to change that, you know, and I'm going to make sure that what I'm doing is going to be something that's going to be respected. And that's the key, respected, you know, because no matter what you do or what you see, you always want to, you know, be respected, no matter if you go crazy or whatever, but you want to have an identity along with it. Don't laugh.
I'd rather
the crazy be there. I'm gonna be honest. I'm not a cray cray person. I'm a very, very, like, I'm probably like most. No, you're crazy. I am probably like the most. I don't know. I don't deal with drama. I don't deal with cray cray. I laugh at it. I think when people are at crazy, I laugh, because I just think it's just like an emotion that they have that they just need to succumb. You know, you just need to get over that. But I think that if people really in tune with themselves and really know and really think before you do something, these crazy reactions won't happen. And I know people will take you to certain limits. People will make you do all kinds of things, but it's a test. It's only a test. And if you believe in God, guess what? God's going to surpass every test that everybody's trying to put you through. The only test that you should be going through is the test that he puts you through. And that's
true.
That's,
and that's what you
but
feel.
I want to hear amen. Y'all just say amen.
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 No, I was about to do my own applause to myself, you know? So, you know, that's why people talk to themselves, because people don't respond. You know what I mean? So you got to talk to yourself. I talk to myself when there is no one to talk to. You heard that song.
Well, you got people here on the phone to talk to right now, so you need a skin air and let them talk. Because, man, damn, okay, you just got me depressed. I feel like I need to go pop a Xanax or something. I'm like, damn, she just
oh,
all my happiness.
No. That is who can I run to?
You know what? Look at the bright side. You're still smiling today, aren't you? You're blessed, you're thankful, and you're smiling today. You're moving
right
along.
Oh, my God.
We're moving right along.
Yes, we are moving right along. Oh, my God. Okay, anyway. So, okay, great question. Outside of Greatest Gift, which obviously was one of the songs that you feel the most passionate about, what's one of the other songs that you actually wrote, not just that you sang, but that you actually wrote, that you feel as soon as you heard that song, you was like, okay, wow, this is going to make the world feel really, really good.
I would say Step Aside by Yolanda Adams. And basically what it's saying is that whenever when you're going through something, sometimes you don't have to fight your own battles. You just step aside and let God do it. So basically, that's what that song was about. Like, you know, cast your cares on him because he cares. He loves you. And he wants the best for you. But sometimes you just got to sit down and step aside. Because sometimes we get ourselves in situations it's going to take God to get us out of. So that was like one of my most passionate. And when I was writing it, I said, okay, this is Yolanda. This is her. I know she could take this. Mm-hmm. But, you know, I was blessed that even Tamela Mann, she put it on her album, the same song on her album.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Oh, nice.
So that was one of my other passionate songs that was written.
Nice. Yeah, sometimes you got to let God just take over, man. You know, especially when you're crazy and you don't know which voice to listen to, Rose. And,
but honestly, Mike, I think everybody have a little crazy in them.
Absolutely.
It's just knowing how to tame that craziness.
But see, that's when
you can't tame it.
You see,
no,
that's when you know you're crazy. When you can't tame
because,
the crazy.
Because it's tameable don't mean that you can't be.
Well, that's what I'm trying to tell you. So if you can't tame the crazy, you crazy. I mean, it's just that
simple.
No,
like, you know what, Mike?
Untameable.
I'll say this. Let me share this with you, Tamika, if you don't
mind.
You're
just trying to defend
like,
all
I'll
the crazy people out there. Go ahead.
No, seriously, I'll say this. Like, I would say, you know, like when you first meet someone, and Tamika, we can kind of digress with this together. Okay, so when I first, you know, started talking to Mika, we talked. We had a great conversation.
Yeah.
And at the
yes,
end of the conversation, Tamika was like, you are so crazy, but you're funny as hell. You know what I mean? But it's just like, it's not a crazy in a bad way. It's just that,
right,
you know what I mean? I'm
right.
being myself. You know what I mean? I don't
right.
have
it's
to be
crazy
guarded.
It's a crazy acknowledgement is what it is.
You stupid.
Amongst
like,
crazy people.
Crazy acknowledges the crazy in you.
Exactly. Amongst crazy people. You're so crazy. I see that.
Y'all are mess. I'm going to let y'all have that one for tonight. I'm going to let y'all have that one. It's too late.
I mean, you know, Tamika, all right, seriously. Tamika, Rose, do y'all think I'm crazy? Like, I am not, like.
No, you're not.
I don't want you to answer, Mike. I don't want Darrin to answer.
Wait, before you do that, I got one question to ask. Was your national anthem by Jasmine Sullivan Bust the Windows Out Your Car? Yes or no?
No,
that
was
wasn't
mine.
Me.
That was Rose.
That was Rose. That wasn't me.
Yeah, but.
Wow.
But Mo was loving it too, because Mo from Philly, she experienced that. That's all it is. She was busting the windows out the car.
No, you're wrong.
No, I said I've seen it.
I never bust anybody's windows out of the car. I never did that. Are you sick? No.
What's wrong? Is
okay,
the open court
so
case right now? We understand.
Original.
You can't admit it.
No, I've never bust anybody's windows out of the car.
Did
you crazy?
I didn't do that. Mo, did you ever say, I didn't do that, but I understand?
No,
for real.
I never did. I did say that. I never did that, but I understand where they're coming from. But that's not a sign of crazy.
You know, Z, this is what Mo actually told me. One day we were talking, and she was like, you know what, bro?
Oh, my God.
I ain't no killer, but don't push me. And I was like, what? Huh?
That's a crazy ass statement.
I ain't no killer, but don't push me. So,
That's a crazy ass statement.
Tamika, call in.
Tupac. She was just quoting
Tamika.
One of Tupac's songs. That's all. That don't mean she crazy.
She's just
going
to Tupac
songs.
Okay.
First of all, here's the thing.
Yeah, that's the end of Tupac.
I don't have cray-cray signs. I don't have that. First of all, I'm a realist. If you do something to me, it's going to take a lot for me to just retaliate because I don't believe in that. You know what I mean? I just believe wholeheartedly, to be seriously. I believe that karma is a bitch, okay? So whatever you do to me is going to come back to you. So I don't have time to sit and waste and try to figure out how I'm going to be crazy and get you back. I'm not going to do any of that. I'm going to let karma deal with that. I'm going to let God deal with that, and I'm just going to keep moving. Now, if you want to call me crazy because I just like to have fun, I like to laugh, I like to joke, then fine, you could call me crazy because of that. But I'm not crazy because, you know, I'm trying to do something to somebody. I'm just a jovial person. I like to have fun.
Yeah.
I like to joke. I like to laugh. I like to make other people. I just like making people. I just like a happy environment. That's just
See,
me.
I think
so
like Mike said,
crazy,
all of this
ahead.
Could be, all of that could be avoided, like Mike said at the beginning of the show. Listen when they talk.
For real.
Listen when they talk.
And on that note, I'm like D in this situation because there's no way I'm going to turn the other cheek. I'm sorry. I know God going to handle and all that stuff, but I need some hands in it too. I'm sorry. I'm a work in progress. I got to work for me because I'm going to get you back. I'm sorry.
That's crazy, Mike. I mean,
I'm with you.
If somebody comes up, and punches the crap out of you, so you're going to turn around and punch them back?
Hell yeah!
Hey,
dude,
you gonna put me in pain?
And I'm gonna look at you, and I'm gonna say, "Oh, that's all right, dog. You know, it didn't hurt that bad." Really? I'm just gonna turn the cheek. Really? There's a name for that,
Tamika.
What is it? Being feminine fingers.
I'm just joking.
Been in a situation where you or a family member or a friend has actually done something that they regretted doing, regretted after they've done it, whereas emotions took over you, you were reactionary, and you did something that could have been a violation to a person's property or their own physical body, where, you know, you wish that you hadn't done that because you weren't in your right mind.
Now, if it's an open place still, don't speak on it.
Yes.
Well, I mean, the younger Tamika, the 10 years ago Tamika and on to, you know, teenage years, yeah, I had a mean streak. I actually got put out of school because one thing about me is I'm family-oriented, and if you come after my family, that's how I was then. I would come after you. So if you did anything, like a lot of things happened to my sister in school. People used to always try to bully her, and she's 2 years older than me. So I was a little big sister. Like people would say things to her, and she would just, you know, she's like, you know, I'm gonna let God deal with it. It takes a lot to really get her upset. But when you bag her in the corner, she come out fighting. You're like, what's wrong with her? See, I was the one. You're not gonna disrespect me because I don't disrespect you. So, yeah, it was a girl messing with her in school, and I went to her school. I went to the school, her class, with a knife, and I chopped her up, and I got locked up. I got put out of middle school.
Okay.
I got put out of middle school, and I got kicked out of Clayton County Schools, and I couldn't go back. But, you know, that was because I was taken up for someone I love. So, you know,
I understand that.
That was a long time ago. That's the old cray-cray. Even, you know, not trying to elaborate on the interview that I did with Candy, it was a lot of things said about my sister, and my sister never said anything. She never tried to tell her side of the story, and I got fed up. You know, the 10 years ago Tamika got fed up, and you know, they say all is fair in war, so I just let it rip. So it's like you're doing all these interviews, you're saying all this about my sister. Let me just let the world know what it really is. So, you know, and I regret doing that because, you know, it's just like you said, there's a certain way that you need to handle it. I feel like it should have been handled face-to-face, being that we were friends. But the fact that the other party didn't see it that way, I had to react ignorant. So, you know, I did apologize for saying things that I shouldn't. You know, I shouldn't have. Don't nobody want to know who's sleeping with who. I don't want nobody to know who I'm sleeping with. Well, I can tell y'all who I'm sleeping with right now. I'm sleeping with my baby, daddy, my husband. But, you know, people don't want, you know, that was the old Tamika. That was the old Tamika. So, you know, I did apologize for reacting the way that I did. I should have did it differently. But, you know, looking back on that now, like you said, Darrin, do I regret it? Maybe, you know, yeah, but no. But I would definitely handle it differently now that I'm more okay. Mature, I'm more wiser. Just don't mess with my family. Don't Lord knows don't mess with my kids. You're gonna leave that as
yeah. There's
as
a lot of cameras. Yes. There's a lot of cameras out there. You definitely got to handle it a lot different these days. You know, in the back of the day, you can handle it up front. You got to close some doors, make sure the windows are closed, everything's barred, curtains full closed, no cameras around, no court cases.
That was the old Tamika. The new Tamika, you know, when I became a man, I put away childish things. I put away those childish things, so now I'm a woman. So I deal with things totally different.
I think right now what I'm going to say, and I'm going to say it to the people on the phone, to know me is to know that once you're in my circle and, you know, I have befriended you, that no one can do or say anything in regards to you. Now, if you want to call that cray-cray, because if someone says something about you guys, I am going to snap. We had an episode today, but I am going to snap. So if anybody says anything if anybody says anything about you guys, then that's when I'm going to have my cray-cray moment. And I'm being honest, because I really believe that, you know, once you have people in your circle, you believe in them, you trust in them, and, you know, you can see what the future holds. No one else can come in and try to deter that for me, you know. And I'm like, you know, that type of person. Like, some people say, you know, I'm real nurturing and those type of things. And I just feel like anything that I believe in, then I'm going to fight for it. You know, and if someone tries to come about to say something negative in regards to the things that I'm fighting for, yeah, I may be a little cray cray. I'll admit that I'll be a little cray cray. You might not like what I say, but
we love your crazy ass, Mo. We love you.
Yeah, we love you, Mo. We love your crazy ass. Okay, anyway.
Yeah, I might be a little cray cray. Darrin,
man.
I might be a little cray-cray on you, okay? So I might have to,
I'm okay with it. I know how to deal with your cray-cray.
That's what's up. Oh, a lot of love on the phone. A lot of love on the phone amongst crazy-ass people. Man, so if you're tuning in from the asylum, give us a call right now. Man, God.
Did you say asylum? Did you really say that?
Yeah, man. Okay. It's about time for Rose to get back in there, right? Hey, Rose, what's the hours that you're allowed to stay out from?
I just have to be in by 11. That's just to get my meds and to go to bed. So I have a little more time to hang out.
Oh, cool. Hey, are we on the radio inside the break room or inside the bathroom?
Have you guys ever heard this? People say people get crazy and they lose sight of reality. Do you believe in that? When they get crazy, do they lose sight of reality?
I think reality is relative to a person's perspective. A person can just see what they want to see, but doesn't see the full spectrum of the situation because they're looking at it from their point of view. So yeah, they can be out of touch of reality, but reality says. And within itself is a 360 degree, right, perspective. But if a person is only looking at it from this side, you know, then
that's the only thing they're getting. You know, they say it's your truth, their truth, and the truth. So it's really three different sides. So, yeah, people can lose touch with that. Absolutely.
Of course.
Because of emotion.
Okay.
Yep. You do it all the time.
Excuse me?
I say nothing.
You say I do it all. Okay. All right. I'm ready. Okay.
Anyway, what's up, Tamika? Hey, Tamika, is there anything else that you want us to know about you? Because we really enjoyed you on this phone tonight, and we know you got a lot of questions.
Well, I am, you know, despite my past, I am a good person. I am a good-hearted person, a real loyal friend to those who I'm friends with, and I would like to believe that I'm a great mom and a great wife and all of that. So, and talented at the same time. That's it. And I'm
okay,
real. I'm real. So, you know, there's no faking when it comes to me. I think I'm as real as it gets. And sometimes some people can't handle real, but that's my first, middle, and last name.
Okay.
So. Okay.
That's why Darrin loved me so much. Isn't that right, Big Mo?
Don't forget me.
You too, Mo.
You know what's so amazing? I look forward to being on the radio every Tuesday. I look forward to the interviews. I look forward to situations like this because not only are our listeners learning, but we're growing. We're working things out. This is a therapeutic moment for all these people listening as well. And for those people who have been in relationships, who have been wronged before, remember that it just simply means that a person was not ready to receive what you were ready to give. So it was time for them to go. There are lessons that each individual is learning for their individual selves. And don't necessarily think that someone is always doing something to you, but they may be doing it for you.
Great point.
Well said, Dehan.
Very well.
That's why Darrin is the man.
Hey,
I'm just a man next to the man, next to the woman, next to the woman.
You left out one woman next to the other woman that's on the phone.
And next to the woman.
There you go. Oh, my God. Hey, Mika, we really, really, really appreciate you being on this phone with us tonight.
Thank you all for having me. I had a wonderful time. I enjoyed myself. I did.
Now, we enjoyed
ourselves.
And you
can come back anytime. You have now been nominated a part of the Solix family. So,
Thank you. You are forever welcome here.
Forever welcome. Be a part of the show.
Yes.
Just call in. Let me know. We can make you a part of the show. Just to let you know, the listeners know, we will be having a Solix book tour, which will feature the authors on the call, such as Darrin Henson, Rose Bush, and myself, Monica Elam. And it would be hosted by, what's your name, Mike?
some dude. It's gonna be some dude on there hosting it.
That
just happened to have an okay voice.
But Solix has a lot coming in store for you guys, and we appreciate you guys tuning in every Tuesday at 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, 6 p.m. Pacific Standard Time, and we will do this every Tuesday. So feel free to call in and connect with us throughout the week. Send in your questions, your comments to at Solix, whether it's on Instagram or Twitter. We can answer those. And for each and every one that's on the line, Tamika, tell them where they can find you on your social media.
Well, you can find me on Instagram, The Real Tamika Scott, and that's with an I. My Twitter is Official T Scott, and my Facebook is Tamika Scott.
Great.
And www.tamikascott.com.
And Mike, who just, you know, became into social media, he decided to use his fingers. Mike, where can we find you?
Anything that says Mike, a voice to men, or Bite Mike, voice to men, Twitter, Facebook, all that stuff, you'll find me right there. And then, you know, just talking up some nonsense and letting y'all know what the real deal is out here in this world. Don't contact me if you don't want to know the truth. I'll tell you that up front.
D Hen, where can we find you?
My Twitter is Mr. D Hen. That's M R D H E N. My Facebook is Darrin DeWitt Henson, and y'all already know I'm all over Instagram. Keep tuning in with us. Keep coming back every Tuesday night, 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. We love you. Go on our website, pick up a copy of our books, come out on the book tour, and do not forget to support Tamika in her play.
Yes.
And I will be seeing
that
everybody soon, because I will be out on the road very soon as well.
Okay. And Rose,
where
can we find you, love?
Let's see, on Instagram and on Twitter, I am RoseBush25. On Facebook, it is just RoseBush. That's me.
Okay.
With backslash
and
asylum.
And for me, it's Essence of Mo on Instagram and Twitter. Make sure you follow me, MonicaElam.com for the website. And for Facebook, it's either Monica.A.Anderson or Monica Elam author page. But I do want to give a couple shout-outs because I always want to recognize all of our hosts on the show and guests that come on the show and different things that they're doing. Again, let's just kind of go over with, you know, Tamika, she's going to be head over heels, and the play is coming out, and she's going to be in Tennessee, Alabama, and Birmingham, as well as Huntsville. And we have Darrin doing Married but Single. His tour is coming out, where he's going to be featured with Lisa Ray McCoy, Chrisette Michelle. So that's going to be happening between March and May, so make sure you tune into those things. And also make sure you tune into our book tour, which will be sponsored by us. And guess what? With all of the things that we're doing them for you to bring knowledge and give back to each and every person that has been in our career. And we love you so much. And, Mike, you can take us out.
Yes, we do. Yes, we do. We do love you. We thank you for joining us for another version of Soul Licks. We love you, as you already know. Tune in every Tuesday night. God bless y'all. Good night.
Good night.
Good night.
Oh, and don't forget, if you're in Jacksonville, Florida, Rose and Mo has a book tour going on. Peace. Good night.
Good night.
Good night.
We rockin' on Solix, Solix. Conversations on a hot couch, grown folks talk. You might need to turn the lights out. It gets a bit explicit. You're lucky if you get to pay a visit. We got the best guests in the audience. Listen, we got them tuned in. I suggest you pay attention. Every Tuesday, you better not miss it. Kicking off live. Live. So turn your volumes up and get tuned with the vibe. We rockin' on Solix. Never converse like this before. We rock it on Solix, Solix. Didn't expect a hot cover. We rock it on Solix. Never converse like this before. We rock it on Solix, Solix. Didn't expect a hot cover. We rock it on Solix. Never converse like this before. We rock it on Solix, Solix. Didn't expect a hot cover. We rockin' on Solix, never converse like this before. We rockin' on Solix, Solix, didn't expect a hot cow. We rockin' on Solix. We rockin' on Solix. We rockin' on Solix. We rockin' on Solix, Solix. Conversations on a hot couch. conversations on a hot couch. Grown folks talk, you might need to turn the lights out. It gets a bit explicit. You're lucky if you get to pay a visit. We got the best guests in the audience. Listen, we got them tuned in. I suggest you pay attention. Every Tuesday, you better not miss it. Kicking off live. Live. So turn your volumes up and get tuned with the vibe. We're rocking on soul. Never converse like this before.
This is the sound of a University of Phoenix student earning a master's degree. What you don't hear is the courage it took to put goodness on hold for greatness, the sacrifice it took to substitute hobbies for homework, and the fight it took to keep going when settling seemed easy. You don't hear the kids that need attention, the boss that needs reports, the pressure that shapes this student into a success. So next time you look at a University of Phoenix degree, know it's not as simple as it sounds. And that's why we rise. University of Phoenix. Learn more at phoenix.edu.